So what features do you want in a boat building workshop? Well, obviously you'll need to have space for the boat that you're building, but you'll also want to have some space around it. If your space allows you to view the boat from a bit of a distance, it's ideal because it allows you to better evaluate the shape of the boat as you're building it. Also, it's great if your space is big enough for you to turn around a plank that's as long as the boat. My workshop here is 4 meters wide, and the canoe that I've just finished is 3.5 meters, which means that I can turn around a whole plank without having to go outdoors. And this might seem obvious, but you have to make sure that you can get your boat out of the workshop. You don't want to have to make the choice between cutting up your boat and cutting up your shop door. You don't necessarily need to have stationary machines to build your first boat, but if you do have a bandsaw or a thickness planer, you'll want to have sufficient infeed and outfeed to process planks the full length of the boat. A lot of the work you'll be doing will take place on the boat itself, but you'll also want a workbench. As you'll be working on very long work pieces, a long workbench is best. The longer the better. It's important that the workbench is stable and rigid, because when you work with hand tools, you exert a lot of force on the workpiece. My workbench is actually not a typical boat builder's bench. It's more of a cabinet maker's bench. Most boat shops have long benches along the walls made of simple 2-inch construction lumber and attached to the walls, and with legs that are attached to the floor for stability and rigidity. If you have a workbench already that's not very long, you can get by using that and perhaps using a sawhorse as a bench extension for all your long work pieces. The workbench will need to have some sort of vise. My workbench has a leg vise, but for a lot of boat building tasks, I actually use a metal working vise because it makes it a lot easier to hold many of the odd shaped pieces that go into a boat. The next thing you'll need is storage, both for your wood, but also for your tools and your other boat building materials. I have this shelving that I use for my long pieces of wood, but anything goes as long as it fits the space that you have available. I've put a bit of time into making some wall racks for my most used hand tools. And this is simply a way of reducing clutter, because if it's really easy to put a tool back into its proper place, I tend to do it instead of just leaving it on the workbench when I proceed with the next task. A few final things you'll want to consider for your workshop is lighting, electricity, water, and heating. For lighting, if you have natural light, it's great, but you'll probably also want some general lighting, and you'll want some focused lamps for detail work. Electricity is obviously necessary for lighting and for power tools. Access to a sink with running water is great to have, especially when you're painting and varnishing your boat. My workshop is not heated, and the temperature varies from around 10 degrees centigrade in the winter to 25 degrees centigrade in the summer, which is okay for the type of work that I do. It's best if your boat shop does not get below the freezing point, because that can have negative effects on the glues that you'll be using. So those are the functional basics of your workshop. But you'll be spending many hours in this shop, so I suggest that you make an effort in trying to make it as comfortable and as inviting as possible. Harry Bryan, who designed the Fiddlehead Canoe, suggests that you have a pondering chair in your workshop, which is essentially an easy chair that you can use for your breaks, you can use them for drinking coffee, you can use them when you have a guest stopping by, or when you need to consider the next steps in your project, or simply just admire the work that you've done.